Welcome students, today we are going to see the next important topic in the second unit, ferrous alloys of course PH8251 materials science. In today's lecture we are going to talk about TTT diagram, that is time temperature transformation diagram of a eutectoid steel. So this particular topic is more important because of its special informatic and application oriented aspects. So this diagram also called as isothermal transformation diagram. Now let us talk about the TTT diagram of iron carbon system, in particularly the eutectoid steel. So in our previous discussion we are discussed so many aspects of iron carbon phase diagram, where the variation of microstructures and phases with respect to the composition of iron and carbon in the alloy system. So we observed when the carbon percentage becomes more than 0.02, no longer these alloys forms a complete solid solution, and we have observed so many invariant reactions at different temperature, and that results so many solid phase transitions from austenite to alpha ferrite, cementite, pearlite and etc. So today in this TTT diagram we are going to see much more required informations from this phase diagram, where the time induced transformation in structural changes which is happening in a fixed composition of alloy system. So it is very important to analyze the structural changes that is happening when the time progresses. Such information can be obtained by this kind of TTT diagram. So here in this TTT diagram we are going to record the phase transformation with respect to time and temperature. Now let us see the topic elaborately. As an introduction, TTT diagram is a diagram shows the transformation from austenite into other micro structures or micro constituents when it is cooled from its upper critical temperature to a constant temperature in an eutectoid steel. So we all know that when this iron carbon system, in particular eutectoid steel, this is the iron carbon alloy where we are having fixed carbon composition of 0.8% in the total alloy. So in this particular composition we may take the alloy system to higher temperature, much elaborated higher temperature, and we cool that from higher temperature to lower temperature levels, we could able to see different microstructural changes. So here we are going to consider the structural changes from the upper critical temperature, let us say 723 degrees Celsius, which is termed as eutectoid temperature for this steel. So the behavior of steel when cooled at different rates from austenite state is obtained from the help of TTT diagram. So this TTT diagram theoretically it is very very much useful for understanding the various time dependent transformations and other applications of TTT diagram is listed here. The first most is nature and type of transformation can be understood, and the rate of transformation in a particular temperature can be understood, and stability of phases with respect to temperature and the time can be analyzed. Time required or temperature required to start or finish a transformation can be understood. Qualitative information about size of the product and nature of the structure can be obtained. And we are also understand the hardness of transformed product we can measure from this particular diagram. So overall, comparing to the normal iron carbon phase diagram what we have discussed earlier, we can able to get more information from this type of TTT diagram. So that's why this is called isothermal diagram, and this TTT stands for time temperature transformation diagram. So here we are going to relate these three parameters to get the required information as a analysis. Now let us see the diagram of a U-tectile steel, and once again reminding you, U-tectile steel is nothing but this is the steel where the carbon concentration is 0.8%. Now as our analysis, let us start with the understanding of different microstructures what we are going to observe in steel. The first is pyrolite. So we all know that from our previous discussion, the pyrolite is a two-faced lamellar or layered structure composed of alternating layers of alpha ferrite and cementite. So this kind of microstructure normally we see in eutectoid steel when the heating and cooling process happen between 723 degrees Celsius to 550 degrees Celsius. So these kind of pyrolite structures are generally formed by the process called diffusion of carbon from one area to another area. So generally the transformation process, phase transformation, is requires two important process called nucleation and growth. For nucleation, the most important property we require to have diffusion of atom. So diffusion of atom plays a vital role in formation of such microstructures in steel when we see the temperature. The next type of microstructure we can observe in the steel, when we cool the system below 550 degrees Celsius, microstructure what we are observing is a plate-like microstructure that are formed in steel at temperature 550 degrees Celsius to 250 degrees Celsius that are called bainite. So for the creation of bainite-like microstructure, we expect much more rapid cooling comparing to previous one, and this will result in a feathery-like structure, and the size and shape of this bainite as well as pyrolite is depends on the temperature at which this steels are cooled, and the time taken for cooling is allowed also plays a vital role. The third type of microstructure we can observe in the TTT diagramic way, which is called as martensite. This martensite like structure will not be appeared in previous iron carbon phase diagram. So this one is a very important microstructure of steel when it is absorbed at a low temperature and rapid cooling. So here this type of transformation will not happen due to the diffusion of carbon. Here the temperature induced stress play a vital role for producing the diffusionless transformation, where one form of structure is converting into another structure by the pressure which is created in the process. So such type of microstructure which is having body center tetragonal, which is super saturated with carbon in the particular area, here no carbon is allowed to diffuse from one place to another place. This one is a highly, highly strained structure. So this is formed by the diffusionless transformation process in steel. So these three are the different microstructures what we can observe when we analyze the steel when it is cooled in different combinations at different timings and different temperatures. So now let us construct and analyze the TTT diagram, the diagram of the eutectoid steel. How we can construct the time temperature transformation diagram? So here normally the specimen of the steel will be created and that will be heated to much high elevated temperature like 1130 degrees Celsius, and when it is cooled to the temperature above 723 degrees Celsius, whole system will be present as a gamma ferrite, that is austenite. When this high temperature specimen will be cooled by the constant temperature bath, which is filled with molten lead, and temperature of this quenching medium will be taken much below 723 degrees Celsius. So when the temperature is below 723 degrees Celsius, there will be a start of formation of alpha ferrite and cementite in the system, and here we are going to quench this constant temperatured specimen to different temperature by the help of water, and we are going to allow the quenching process for certain interval of time, and each interval of time and each specimen will be observed for the appearance of their microstructure. So based on the appearance of microstructure which is quenched at particular temperature for a particular time will be recorded in the TTT diagram. So what we are going to do, we are going to take a specimen, we are going to quench it with the help of a quenching medium where it is kept in a particular temperature, and the quenching process will allow to happen for a particular time. So for each interval of time we will record the microstructural appearance. One, then the another sample will be taken and that will be again quenched in the same temperature, but now the quenching time will be taken much different. So for varying quenching time we are going to observe the microstructural appearance created in the material, and that appeared microstructures will be analyzed by using the TTT diagram, right? The result of transformation at different temperatures are studied at various time intervals. So this is what the fundamental things we need to observe the in the TTT diagram. So after getting the required data from this experimental process, we can easily construct the so TTT for this we are going to take the required parameter, as we are going to take the temperature in the y-axis and the time interval where we are taking each specimen for analyzing the microstructural creation or appearance will be taken in the x-axis. So here the most fundamental thing is the critical temperature taken as eutectoid temperature, that is 723 degrees Celsius, below which we are going to observe the microstructural appearances. Here if you observe this diagram, this diagram represents the in each temperature of each specimen where the transformation from one space to another phase is starting. So if you are observing this diagram, initially at the high temperature the transformation from austenite to other states will start much it will take much longer time than the lower temperature, say up to 550 degrees Celsius. Below 550 degrees Celsius, again we can observe the transformation process will take higher time as the temperature is decreased. So this is the trend we are going to observe in this diagram. So the left hand side of the diagram shows the initial state of the material, which is in the pure austenite, and right hand side is the region where we are observing the modified phase or transformed phase. So in this single curve, we can represent, we can understand for particular temperature, the time taken for initiating the transformation process. So this green line indicates the initiation time required for initiation of each phase transformations. And so before this green curve, all the phases are present are considered to be austenite. And the next curve what we are observing here is which is marked at red line, and at this time this particular curve represents this is the time when the transformation process is completed. So whether you are taking the transformation from austenite to pearlite, austenite to martensite, bainite, for a particular temperature, the green line represents the time taken for starting of the transformation process. For example, if you take 600 degrees Celsius, so it requires 10 seconds for initiating the transformation from austenite to another phase. And at the meantime, if you take at 500 degrees Celsius, so you are required much less number of seconds to initiate the transformation process, but the time interval taken for completing the process becomes increased compared to the previous stage. So as we discussed earlier, we can observe the different microstructures in the case of a eutectoid steel when it is cooled from the eutectoid temperature. So if we take the alloy is cooled from 723 degrees Celsius to lower temperature, depending on the temperature at which it is cooled and how long it is kept in the particular temperature, it will decide the structure of the resulting product. So in this way, if you take the transformation process between 723 degrees Celsius to 550 degrees Celsius, if the system is taken from 723 degrees Celsius to and more than 550 degrees Celsius, the type of transformation we are observing here is called pearlite transformation. So it will at the higher temperatures, at the higher temperature near to 723 degrees Celsius, the transformation process will start lately and the transformation completes much quickly. And in the case of 550 degrees Celsius nearby, that the transformation process starts much early and it will complete much later. So depending on the temperature, whether you are reaching the temperature of 723 degrees Celsius quickly or the temperature around 550 degrees Celsius quickly, you can able to observe the resultant product of pearlite get changed. So in this way, by the appearance of pearlite which is formed in the structure, which may be a coarse pearlite or fine pearlite. So once again, I want to remind you, pearlite is nothing but a layer structure where alternate layers of alpha ferrite and cementites are placed over one another. So in the case of coarse pearlite, the thickness of these layers will be very large, and in the case of fine pearlite, the thickness of these layers will be very thin. So when the austenite is taken to higher temperature very near to 723 degrees Celsius, that will result coarse pearlite when it is kept for some amount of time. At the meantime, if the austenite is suddenly cooled to the temperature near to 550 degrees Celsius, it will form a fine pearlite, and the complete transformation of austenite to fine pearlite will take much higher time comparing to the coarse pearlite. Next, we can observe when the temperature ranges from 550 degrees Celsius to 250 degrees Celsius, when the astrogenite at 723 degrees Celsius is suddenly cooled to 550 degrees Celsius and below, it will form another structure of steel called bainite. So here also the bainite structure will have different appearance when it is taken to the much temperatures lower and lower. So here also the transformation process will be started at one time and it will ends at the after a some interval of time. So each process will taken at the point, if you take the combination of temperature and the time where the transformation process start and the time where the transformation is completed, it can be plotted in the each point in the curve. So in the intermediate phase, you can observe the presence of both astrogenite and the transformed phase. In the case of upper phase of the diagram, you can able to say intermediate between the green curve and red curve, you could able to observe the presence of astrogenite and pearlite, and in the bottom area of the curve, in the intermediate between green and red, you can observe the presence of astrogenite and bainite. So when the system is taken near to the 550 degree Celsius, say 500 degree Celsius, the type of microstructure what we are observing is bainite, and this particular bainite is called as upper bainite. And when we see the bottom of the temperature range, the bainite structure formed is called lower bainite. So these upper bainite and lower bainite are differed by their appearance. The upper bainite will have the structure like feather, and lower bainite will have the structure like somewhat hard and like plate like system. So when we compare the microstructurals of structural appearance of pearlite and bainite, pearlite will have the layered and parallel plate like parallel layered structure. In the case of bainite, they will be like a plate-like structure, and that will be upper bainite and lower bainite, and they will have different appearances in their structural view. And in this diagram, you can able to see a important point called nose, where the temperature at below where this pearlite transformation or bainite transformation will be decided. So in this during these two process, the temperature as well as the time we allow the cooling process to take place, or time we have kept that particular system for in a particular temperature is plays a vital role. So for example, if you take a specimen of 723 degrees Celsius, if we kept that specimen in the quenching process at the constant temperature of 600 degrees Celsius for about 10 to the power 2 seconds, we can able to have a complete transformation of astrogenite into pearlite. At in the meantime, if you taken the system directly to 400 degrees Celsius and we kept the system in the same temperature around 5 to 10 to the power 2 seconds, it will results the structure called bainite. So depending on the temperature we have taken for cooling, the system may resulting in coarse pearlite, fine pearlite, upper bainite or lower bainite. So all these structures are made up of conversion of astrogenite into alpha ferrite and cementite, but their microstructural arrangement will be different. The next important transformation we are going to discuss is martensite. So far in the pearlite as well as bainite, the transformation involves the movement of carbon from one place to another place. So here the diffusion process of carbon from one area to another area plays a vital role when we are providing them some amount of time. Now during the transformation process of astrogenite to martensite, here we are not going to allow or we are not going to provide any amount of time for the transformation process. Here the transformation will happen very, very rapidly and it will be quenched at the very high rate. So this will result in not providing any amount of time for carbon atom to diffuse from one place to another place. So the matter inside is a type of transformation process which is created in the eutectoid steel system, which results somewhat different structural system comparing to other two cases by the process called diffusionless transformation process. Here we are going to quench the high temperature austenite to low temperature below 220 degrees Celsius very rapidly, and this one is not a time dependent process, it is completely the temperature dependent process. When this system is cooled to exactly at 220 degrees Celsius suddenly, so that the martensite structure will form, and the martensite structure is nothing but where the austenite of FCC structure is converting into a body center tetragonal by the process called diffusionless process by the help of stress which is created due to this temperature change. Further, if the same is cooled to the temperature say 150 degrees Celsius at the same time, you could be able to convert austenite into 50% of martensite and remaining will be the austenite. At the meantime, if you quench the system directly to the temperature near 100 degrees Celsius, you could be able to form a 90% martensite and only the 10% of the system will be unconverted. So this unconverted austenite later can be converted into martensite by the process called tempering. So the amount of transformation decided here by the time which the austenite is taken directly. So here the transformation of BCC structured austenite is going to be into a body centered tetragonal by the process called diffusionless transformation with the help of temperature induced stress in the system, where the carbon atoms in the face centered position will occupy the body centered positions in the tetragonal system. So by the way, a FCC austenite system will be converted into a body centered tetragonal system by the process called rapid quenching, and this product is highly hot comparing to other two resultant product. So from this we can understand the different transformation process that are happening, which is time dependent, temperature dependent, how the structure and structure and product is going to be get varied with respect to the time temperature at which this quenching process is happening. Now let us discuss about transformation process. Before that, this is some outline of the previous TTD diagram. So at high temperature transformation, where the quenching speed is very low, that will results the austenite transformation to pearlite when the transformation temperature is taken between 723 degrees Celsius to 550 degrees Celsius. And as we discussed, the size of the resultant product is depends on the temperature at which it is allowed to transform. It is going to vary from coarse to fine. And at the intermediate transformation temperature, that is after 550 degrees Celsius, the it is much rapid quenching than the previous case. Here a black rapid structure known as bainite will be produced. The bainite are highly intermediate temperatures, relatively highly temperature, and we could be able to form two different appearances. As I told you earlier, some of feathery in appearance, which is known as upper bainite, and needle like appearance, which is known as lower bainite, which is forming near the 220 degrees Celsius. So if the rapid quenching is much faster, if the cooling is very rapid, the transformation without the change in the concentration of carbon, because in the previous two process the concentration of carbon in one place to another place will get varied due to the diffusion of carbon from one place to another place. Here no change in the concentration will takes place, and that will results the very hard product called martensite. So here it is more important is that the temperature at which the martensite transformation starts and the temperature at which the martensite completion is takes place. So now let us discuss these transformations one by one. Let us take the paralytic transformation first. So on cooling a steel below the eutectic temperature, a gamma ferrite, that is austenite, transformed to pyrolite, consisting the mixture of alternate parallel plates of alpha ferrite and cementite. So this is what happening here. So in the austenite system, there are 0.8% of carbon, because it is a composition of eutectic steel. By the transformation process to pyrolytic transformation, 0.022% of carbon only going to be retained by the iron system as a interstitial solid solution formation, interstitial solid solution, and a new product called cementite with 0.678% of carbon is going to have the second type of product in there. So these two product will result when the transformation from austenite to pyrolite is happening. So pyrolite is nothing but this is the two product which is placed parallel with one another. Such a product is called pyrolite. So during the process of pyrolite, first the first step of transformation is the formation of alpha ferrite. So here, nucleation of cementite. Here the cementite plate nucleates at the grain boundaries of gamma ferrite. So you can able to see the first stage, you are only having the gamma ferrite as a grains. So when the temperature is lower as the initial state, the cementite plate will nucleate at the boundaries of the austenite. At the second state, this nucleated cementite will reaches the critical size. Once it is reaches the critical size, the alpha ferrite started to nucleate on the boundaries of the cementite by the diffusion of carbon from one area to another area. So as this alternate layers of cementite and alpha ferrite keeps on continuing, and as the result of the last, we will get the layer structure of pyrolite. So here the transformation process is initiated by the formation of cementite plates at the grain boundaries, and alternate layers of alpha ferrite and cementite are keep on forming on the boundary of one another, and that will results the layered structure of pyrolite, where alpha ferrite and cementites are placed parallel to each other. So as we discussed, depending on the temperature we are taken for the transformation process, the resulting pyrolite may have different appearances. They are called coarse pyrolite and fine pyrolite. So technically they require certain conditions, that is, the coarse pyrolite may be formed when the cooling rate is very slow. At the meantime, if the rapid cooling is provided, the fine pyrolite will be formed. So the in the case of coarse pyrolite, the transformation temperature will be high, and in the case of fine pyrolite, the transformation temperature will be low. The coarse pyrolite is obtained in the furnace cooling, and fine pyrolite can be obtained by air cooling. Coarse pyrolites are soft in nature. Fine pyrolites are much harder than the coarse pyrolite. And in the case of coarse pyrolite, the interlamellar spacing is 1 to 2 micrometers. In the case of fine pyrolite, the interlamellar spacing will be 0.1 micrometer. So as I told you, the thickness of the layers will decide whether it is a coarse pyrolite or fine pyrolite. The coarse pyrolite, the thickness of each layer will be high comparing to fine pyrolite. So that will result in the soft nature and hard nature of the both type of pyrolites. So next transformation we are going to study is bainetic transformation. So this is another kind of transformation we are observed in the TTD diagram. So when astenite is cooled rapidly to cross the nose of C curves, that is below 550 degrees Celsius, and kept isothermally in a constant temperature bath, it transformed to an extremely fine non-lamellar mixture of ferrite and carbide, which is known as bainite. So here also we are going to result the ferrite and carbide formation, but by this time we are the resultant is not going to be a layer structure. So this is a non-lamellar structure. So here also what we are observing in the transformation process from the gamma ion, where the iron carbon alloy is forming a interstitial solid solution, where the carbon placing in the face center position. So as a first stage, in the from the gamma ferrite, that is in the austenite, the formation of alpha ferrite is the or nucleation of alpha ferrite is the first stage by the diffusion of carbon from one area to surrounding areas. At the second stage, after reaching the critical size of this alpha ferrite, the cementate will started to nucleate on the boundaries of the alpha ferrite, and that also grow in size as a time progresses. After reaching the certain critical size, again the nucleation of alpha ferrite will start at the boundaries of the cementite, again by the diffusion of carbon from carbon rich area to carbon lower areas. So we will result the areas of carbon rich and carbon lower density lower areas, and that will result the final product called bainite. So depending on the temperature we are taking them to cooling and the time we are providing them to transformation, the resulting bainite structure also two types. One is upper bainite, another one is lower bainite. So the upper bainite, as we discussed, or feathery in shape, and lower bainites are plate-shaped ferrites. So these upper bainites are formed when cooled between 550 degrees Celsius to 350 degrees Celsius, and they show much lower mechanical properties than the lower bainite. And here the resulting carbides are coarse in nature. They will be bigger in size, their grain size will be much larger. In the case of lower bainite, they will be formed when the cooling is happening below the temperature 350 degrees Celsius, and they will have the plate shaped ferrites, and mechanical properties are higher than the upper bainite, and here the carbides are formed in the fine nature. So the appearance of these bainites are represented in the last diagram. So you could be able to see the ferrites are nucleating at the boundaries of austenite, and they will form like a lathe in the boundaries and resulting in the bainite structure. The next important transformation we are going to discuss is the martensitic transformation, which is not discussed in the case of previous iron carbon diagram. So as we discussed, this type of transformation process is happening at the low temperature, where the very rapid coolings are achieved, and here the resultant product will not get having any change in the carbon composition, and this is achieved by the diffusionless process or very low diffusion rate of carbon. So the martensite is a very hard structure of steel, where you are having the transformation process achieved from austenite to the hard structure called martensite by the process called diffusionless transformation process. Here the transformation is aided by the temperature induced stress. So by using the stress, the expansion of FCC system of austenite will result the body center tetragonal. So this is what happening here. The austenite of FCC system is going to be converted into martensite of BCT, that is body center tetragonal. In both the cases, the total percentage of carbon present in the resultant product is 0.8% of carbon. So there are very important mechanism which involves in Martensite transformation is the shear mechanism, where the FCC crystal system is sheared to produce BCT. The FCC crystal system of arsenide is converted into BCT of martensite by the diffusionless manner of a shear. So this shear is obtained from the rapid cooling. It is been obtained by the stress release of temperature. So the interstitial carbon occupies in the octahedral voids of FCC located at the body center and at the 12 edges centers of the FCC unit cells. So here the carbon in the FCC system will occupies the octahedral voids in the BCC system. During the shear transformation, the vertical C axis expands by 20% and the horizontal A1, A2 axis expand about 12% each. So as we discussed, the martensite progresses, it is not going to happen in a single temperature. This will start at the temperature called MS, where the nucleation starts, and from that nucleation point the growth will continue, and that will complete transformation will be ends at the temperature called MF. So this MS MF will be changing with respect to the percentage of carbon and the other allying element present in the system. So depending on the temperature and composition we are having, the morphology of the martensite will be get varied. They are called lath martensite and plate martensite. At low concentration of carbon and the alloying elements, at all high temperature, lath martensite forms. The plate martensite, the high concentration of carbon and the alloying elements and lower transformation temperature, that is lower means much near to 100 degrees Celsius, you will result with plate martensite transformation. So these are the two different martensite we can observe in the case of eutectite steel. So this is the difference in the martensite, lath martensite and plate martensite, or sometimes called as lenticular martensite. So here the difference in the martensite systems are represented here. So in the whole process, some of the arsenide may present in the system which is been present unconverted arsenide. So to convert that martensite, we are using the process called tampering. So the tampering is nothing but reheating the martensite to high temperature and slow and cooling them is called tampering. So by the tampering process, we can eliminate quenching stresses which is created in the system, and we can restore some ductility in the martensite, because martensite are highly hard and they will have very low ductility. So to improve the ductility to some extent, we can do this tempering of martensite. So during this martensite tempering process, the unconverted arsenide present in the system will be converted into the martensite state, and this will be happen in different stages depending on the temperature, and that will results different end characteristics of this product. In the stage 1, it can be taken to 80 degrees Celsius to 200 degrees Celsius, and that will results in martensite decomposes into two phases, which is called low carbon martensite and carbides. So the excess carbide will be released from the system by the diffusion process. The separation of carbon atom from the space lattice of the tetragonal martensite, that will results the carbides, and during this process the internal stress are removed and ductility will be increased. So when the martensite is taken to the temperature 200 to 300 degrees Celsius and it is cooled again to the low temperature, that will results the decomposition of residual arsenide to bainite, and it will decreases the hardness and increases the ductility further. In stage 3, if you are willing to take the system to the temperature 300 degrees Celsius to 500 degrees Celsius, that will do the process of conversion of low carbon martensite and eta carbide into a cementite and alpha ferrite, and this will results the rapid softening of the system, and if these martensites are alloyed with some of the alloying element, the stage 4 is maybe used to convert the carbides into alloy steels. So in this stage, the whole martensite system will be taken to the temperature around 400 to 700 degrees Celsius. Normally this stage is meant for alloys only, so alloy steels only. So this is the different stages or different temperature levels we can take a martensite steel to achieve certain properties. So by this tempering process, we can able to achieve the process of converting not converted arsenite into bainite. So this is called tempering process of martensite. Thank you.